Dalton's law of partial pressure will be easily explained in this video with animation. Let's say we have a container with three different gases. Gas 1, gas 2, and gas 3. Note that the gases are all inside the same container. This means that they all have the same volume. Now let's take the same container and spread the gases out equally while holding the volume constant in each container. The sum of the partial pressures of the three gases will equal the total pressure of the mixture of gases. Let's look at the pressure meters above the gas chambers to notice that each partial pressure of the individual gases equals the pressure of all the gases in the same container. Now let's look at the formula for Dalton's law of partial pressure. First, let's derive the ideal gas law, where pressure times volume equals nRT. We can see that the pressure is equal to nRT over V. Now let's look at Dalton's law of partial pressure, where at a constant volume, we can add the partial pressure volumes of the individual gases to equal the total pressure of the combined gases. Let's do a sample question here. A gas mixture contains hydrogen, helium, neon, and argon. The total pressure of the mixture is 93.6 kilopascals. The partial pressures of helium, neon, and argon are 15.4 kilopascals, 24.7 kPa, and 35.6 kPa, respectively. What is the pressure extended by hydrogen? So we know that the total pressure is equal to 93.6 kilopascals of pressure, and we have the pressures of the other three gases in the mixture. We also know that all the units are the same, and we don't have to do any mole conversions. So all we need to do is add up the three individual pressures and subtract them from the total to get the pressure of hydrogen, which is 16.9 kilopascals. This question uses Dalton's law of partial pressures perfectly. Thanks for watching. We hope you found this video helpful. Be sure to like and subscribe for more new videos.